Welcome to our special session, which is highlighting research by the Livestock GraceNet Research Group. It looks like it's mostly the group this morning. So I'm going to be telling you what you already know, but since some of you won't respond to me, I think I need a little refresher about what we do and what we're going to do. So, yeah, or what I'm hoping that I can get you to do, perhaps, is the right word. So, my name is April Latham, if you don't know me, and I was kind of the person that thought that we should put a group of scientists together that are working on livestock emissions, mostly because one of the comments I tend to get when I actually on our Oscar reviews is when it mostly happens and I tell people, our plan is to measure emissions, you know, for the next couple years at one dairy. Well, I always get the response, well, you need to do, you know, 4 or 10 dairies. And I'm always thinking, well, if you'd like to give me $2 to $5 million, I'd be more than happy to measure emissions on multiple sites all the time. But unfortunately, if you work in this area, you know how expensive it is and how difficult it is even to monitor one commercial production facility, let alone multiple ones. And so one of the ideas is collectively, if a bunch of us are doing the same kind of work and we pool our resources and our data, perhaps in the end we've kind of accomplished the big goal of having multiple sites that have been monitored that we can look at and get greater value out of a pool of data instead of the individual scientist's data. So our mission was to lead the development of livestock management practices to reduce greenhouse gas, ammonia, and other emissions, and provide a sound scientific basis for accurate measurement and modeling of emissions. So our ideas for the group was that we were going to collaborate with fellow scientists and stakeholders to identify and develop these management practices, to support the needs of policymakers and regulators for consistent, accurate data and information, hopefully foster transparency in our scientific methods and rigor, and to transfer new knowledge efficiently to stakeholders in the scientific community. So at the moment, there are 24 scientists located at 13 locations spread out across the country, and we focus on everything from beef to dairy to swine and poultry. And the products are some of our goals for products that we had. Number one, to have a methods manual. So basically a set of protocols and methods that would be available for people that were interested in doing this kind of work to give you an idea of the types of, given the equipment that you have and the system that you're working in, what would be some of the best methods to do emissions on that facility. And maybe even more importantly, what data you really should be collecting when you're doing it so that it adds to a larger database that could be used by more than just that project maybe. To develop some fact sheets, and we do have some fact sheets out on the table outside the room here. Basically, they're 2-page fact sheets describing management practices that can be used on farm to reduce emissions. The database, I think, could be one of the key elements, and that would be to compile the emissions data from a variety of livestock production systems in different regions. And this data could then be further used by people developing models, testing models, validating models, or any other use that people might have for that, to enhance collaboration between scientists and to hopefully interact with other agencies. So I did develop a livestock GraceNet website this year, although some of you didn't even know that. I swear I sent out the link. This is kind of what it looks like at the moment. It's kind of skinny, but it hopefully will grow at some point. I do have a page that kind of describes the group, although the resolution on the screen just seems to be pretty bad. A page with a link to our fact sheets and a page with a link to the scientists that work in Livestock GraceNet and what they do. And our fact sheets kind of all look the same. 2 pages, well, they basically describe a management practice that can be used on farm, include how you implement it, and hopefully even the cost that you would expect for implementing that practice. And there are the ones that have been turned in. There are examples of them out on the table outside the room if anyone's interested in those. And the future of Livestock GraceNet, it could be changing. At the moment, it is an ARS group, but there has been some interest from the Global Research Alliance to open the group up to any interested parties. And if you don't know who the Global Research Alliance is, They do research looking at greenhouse gas emissions from rice, livestock, and crops. And in this case, it's the livestock research group that's kind of interested in maybe joining forces with us or collaborating with us to expand our reach beyond just being an ARS group. And their main goal is to improve greenhouse gas intensity of livestock production systems, increase quantity of carbon stored in soils, and they're really focused on methane and enteric fermentation and waste management and nitrous oxide from animal waste and fertilizers. So today's session has 9 presentations that will highlight some of the work done by our scientists. Philip Moore would have been in our group, but he had to leave yesterday, so some of you may have seen the talk he gave looking at the uses of ammonia scrubbers in dairy production. And unfortunately, Al Rotz presently is in a competing session talking right now. So, but other than that, we have a pretty good collection here. And another thing that's hopefully going to be coming out soon is Rob Dungan is one of the technical editors for the Journal of Environmental Quality, and we're going to put together a special JEQ issue that's going to highlight some of the research done by our group. So you'll have a collection of papers from the Livestock GraceNet group that you can access through JEQ.